Currently, as I'm recording this video, there are 11 campaign objectives present in the Facebook ad accounts. And I'm going to discuss all of them and let you know the kind of content that you need to put corresponding to each one of them. And by the end of this video, I'll tell you which campaign objective do I choose the most to get the most out of Facebook ads. And you shouldn't miss that part, because selecting an appropriate campaign objective is a very big part of running a successful ad account. In addition, don't directly skip to that part, as you'll get half knowledge, and that is seriously a dangerous thing over here. Also, this video is the part of the Facebook Ads course playlist, and if you want to access the whole course, then click on the I button and you will be able to access the whole course. While making this video, I realized that there are a lot of new terms that I use in the middle of the video, and since most of the audience who is looking at this particular course is fairly new to Facebook ads, so I thought I should explain them before going further into the video. So if you are a person who is aware of the basic terms like CPC, CPM, ROAS, then I would suggest just, you know, look at the timestamp and skip to the good part. For others who are sticking around, let's first talk about CPM. Its full form is cost per milli, and milli is a Latin word which implies 1000. So this is basically cost per 1000 impressions. And impressions are the number of times your content is displayed on the platform. So it is cost per 1000 impressions. As the name suggests, it's the amount you pay for 1000 impressions. And colloquially, we all marketers refer to it, or refer to the CPM, as cost per impression, not 1000 impression. Okay, so whenever someone says cost per impression, that means cost per 1000 impression. Then we have cost per click, which is CPC. So cost per click is the cost you pay when a person clicks on your ad, and it can be in order to share, like save or visit your website. Then we have cost per link click. This is the cost you pay to Facebook when a person clicks on your ad and visits your landing page. Generally, cost per link click is higher than cost per click, and most of the people refer to cost per link click as CPC. So don't get confused when someone is saying that CPC is higher. So basically, when someone says cost per click or CPC, that means cost per link click. Then we have cost per install. So cost per install is basically how much are you paying per install. And then we have cost per video view, which is basically cost per 2 second continuous video play. So whenever someone watches 2 seconds of your videos, you are charged, and that's what is this particular metrics. I hope you got that point. Now let's jump back to the topic of Facebook campaign objectives. Facebook has divided their objectives in 3 sections, namely awareness, consideration, and third one is conversion. These 3 sections are inspired from the marketing funnel, where you first make the person aware of the product or the problem, then push him into the consideration stage by gaining his trust, and finally pushing them to purchase the product. As I discussed a few videos ago on Facebook ad sizes and dimensions, which you can find by clicking on the I button, that depending upon the objectives you choose, you are able to use placements. Not all the placements are available on all the campaign objectives. In this course, I won't be able to discuss which campaign objective allows you which placement, but it's not that hard to figure out that all by yourself. So I'll conveniently skip that part from the course. Go ahead and execute, and you will be able to find which placement is available under which campaign objective. It would be like solving an unnecessary jigsaw puzzle. I thought that I should mention that explicitly over here, and that's what I did. Now let's discuss each section one at a time, starting with awareness. Here, the first one is brand awareness. So Facebook states that this objective is used to increase people's awareness of your business, brand, or service. Therefore, Facebook will try to maximize your ads on those placements where it feels you are getting more awareness. Therefore, when you choose this objective, try to make ad content which helps people know about your brand. Moving on to the next one, which is reach. Facebook will show your ads to as many people as possible in your target audience when you use this particular objective. Here as well, you need to post similar content as we did in the brand awareness campaign or brand awareness campaign objective. In both these objectives, which are under awareness, you will get best cost per impression, which is cost per milli. With that, it's time for our next section, which is consideration. In general, the kind of content you post here will drive the curiosity of the people, so you can talk about solutions to the problem popular amongst the target audience, address FAQs about your services, then publish a few customer testimonials, do unboxing videos, and a lot more. This kind of content makes people want to know more about your brand, and it establishes you as an authority in that space. The first objective that we have here is traffic. This will bring you the cheapest cost per click to the page you want to bring the traffic to. There is no surety whether the people you are bringing in are going to convert or purchase or do the action which you want them to perform. But you get the cheapest traffic, which is low cost per link click. This works best when you are trying to send data to an affiliate website and you don't have pixels installed on that website and therefore can't track the conversions. If you're not able to understand my previous line, then don't worry, just move along. You will understand that at later part of this video. Also, I'm assuming you were able to follow along on the rest of the things. In case you aren't able to, then please mention that in the comment section and I'll address them in the comment section itself or make a video on that particular thing. Please ask away all your doubts. Then comes the second objective in this section, which is engagement, where you get three more options. First one is post engagement, which is used to increase the engagement on your posts, like post reactions, comments, shares, saves, etc. Then we have page likes, which is used to increase the likes on your Facebook page. And finally, we have event responses, which helps you increase responses to the event you made on Facebook. Depending upon your goal, you can choose one of these three. I generally use this one with post engagement only when I know that my client has a good reputation amongst its audience, else this can screw up a lot of things. Through this objective, I get as much engagement as possible on the ad creatives, and then I use that ad creative specifically, which now has a social validation with other objectives, and get better results in those objective campaigns. You have to be very cautious about the fact that Facebook is not able to differentiate between good engagement and bad engagement. So if your client services are bad, then probably it isn't a good idea to do so. Also, in this kind of scenario, always have an online reputation management team to address the grievances. Otherwise, all the other campaigns with other campaign objectives will also suffer because people will take out their frustration in the comment section of those ads as well, plummeting the revenue of your client. With that, we have our next campaign objective, which is app installs. As the name suggests, it will focus on getting you cheaper app installs. You have to give them the place where your app is hosted on the App Store or Google Store or your local website, and Facebook will drive traffic that will get you the cheapest cost per installs. Moving on to our next campaign objective, video view. With this objective, Facebook shares videos of your business with people on Facebook most likely to watch it. So the important matrix to watch here is cost per 2 second continuous video play, which I already discussed, as in how much did you pay for each view, and then the other metrics you need to watch for is the percentage of video that the people watch. Facebook drives traffic that not only watches your video but most probably will stick till the end through this particular objective. And now we move on to the next campaign objective, which is lead generation. So freelancers and B2B owners, if you are watching this particular video, then this is the cheapest way to generate leads for your business. Facebook itself gives you a lead form which opens inside the Facebook itself and people fill it up and submit a lead. But the lead quality is not that good. I'll let you know the remedy by the end of this video, so stick till the end in order to get a better lead quality. The advantage of using this one is that you don't need to, you know, make a form on your website or connect that form to the CRM and install any pixels. So it's a hassle-free process. Facebook takes care of everything for you. The person doesn't even leave Facebook, and most of the basic details are almost auto-filled. And because of such a low friction, the quality is subpar of the leads. With that, it's time for our last objective in the section consideration, which is messages. I use this objective when my client generally doesn't have a website or I want to capture people with high intent and screen out people who are not that qualified on a very, very, very early stage. Needless to say that this objective gets you people who are interested in talking to your business through messages on WhatsApp, Messenger or Instagram. Now, let's move on to the final section, which is conversion. First of all, let's talk about the kind of content that can go here. Here you create urgency by using fear of missing out, which is also known as FOMO. Terms like limited time deal, deal expires before midnight, strike through prices, timer, etc. are the kind of content pieces that are very popular across this section. You have to convey to your customers that it is now or never. And in this section, the first one is conversion. I think I run 96% of my campaigns on conversions, and this is the most beneficial one. In order to run this, you need to have a website and conversion pixels installed on that website. I have already talked about pixels in the start of this particular course, and I'll teach you how to install them in the later part of this course. Now, why is this the most important campaign objective, and why do I rely so heavily on the same? Every business owner wants revenue and big figures in the bottom line. Bottom line is basically the profit, just in case you didn't know. All the other campaigns just create awareness and let the customers know about the brand, regardless if they want to purchase anything or not. With the exception, obviously, of lead generation and message objective, which kind of also help in the revenue generation. So what is the use of creating so much buzz when we can't convert it into money? So that's why it is my favorite one. Here you specifically tell Facebook that I want the person to perform this particular action, and Facebook optimizes the ads to get the minimum cost per that desired action. Also, I use this objective to generate leads. And this is the remedy I was talking about earlier when I talked about lead generation objective. Through this method, I have to make a form and install pixel on my website and get an expensive lead. But because of friction, the quality of that lead is far better than the lead I get through lead generation campaign objective or the message objective. Also, don't worry. In the following videos, I will explain how to create lead generation ad through both conversion objective as well as lead generation objective. Then we have catalogue sales objective. This is very popular amongst e-commerce brands and works similar to the conversion objective. But here you can retarget people with a certain set of specific products from your catalogue. Let's say you know this person visited a page of V-neck t-shirts, and then you can go ahead and show that person a wide variety of V-neck t-shirts from your catalogue. You just have to categorize your catalog properly and Facebook will take care of everything for you. If I'm running ads for an e-commerce store, then the 96% which I mentioned for conversion objective splits into 50-50. So 48% of my campaigns on conversion objective and 48% on catalog objective. Also, don't worry, I'll make a video on the catalog as well in this particular course on how you can categorize them and how to efficiently target people using that. Lastly, we have store traffic. In this case, if you want people to visit a local store, then you can use this particular objective. I tried using it a few times, but it didn't give me any results. So honestly, I never used it again. And that was all about the campaign objective. In the next video, I'll explain the difference between the ad set budget optimization and campaign budget optimization. And which one should you use? Until next time, bye-bye.